I don't feel I ever had a choice. The only thing that I could ever do that signified for me was write stories, invent people, invent situations, because that was the way I made sense of the world. I did it and I do it because I have to do it in order to see where I'm standing, in order to find out, you know, where I am at any given time. And also because I think there's a service involved in working well as an artist. I think this is, you know, I hope it's not too much of a claim, but I don't think it is too much of a claim. I think you serve by working. I think any artist who works conscientiously and does it as well as they can is furthering consciousness to some small degree, and that's service. So I do it because I need to do it, and also because I believe that it's service, and you need to do something beyond serve yourself. I think that if these are people capable of a literary experience, unless they've got themselves in some shape where they just can't do it, they can't have a literary experience because they've cut themselves off, or they made themselves too dumb, or whatever, and this tragically can happen. I think there's one that, you know, there's a literary experience out there of some kind for every intelligent, thoughtful person. There is something that will catch hold of them, and you know, I think you have to know the person, and you know, maybe you can guess what they would like, but I think that there is something sort of for everybody out there. I mean literature is it's necessary. You need stories. I mean, you absolutely need them. You can't locate yourself. People need stories, and they need the beauty of language. Or language can uglify. I mean, a language that kind of is always debased, is always being debased, whether it's on a street or by media, you know, demagogues. The language gets uglier, it gets debased, it loses its meaning. Everything that's good about language, that's useful about language, gets cheapened. It becomes a weapon of deceit, the Rush Limbaughs of the world. It just becomes some kind of dross.